I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please stay tuned for a moment of silence.
Good morning, LC. Welcome to this edition of LC Current. Today is Tuesday, January 11th, and it is a great day. I'm Daniela. And I'm Daniela. We'll be right back with your daily announcement.
Sorry, mi vida, go on.
Bruno says it looks like rain.
Where's the heat alone?
In doing so, he floods my brain.
I will get the umbrella.
Married in a hurricane.
What a joyous day, but anyway.
The Korean Club will be meeting Friday in room 181 until 5:30 p.m. Our theme will be language and cake pop. If you missed the call-out meeting last semester, please join us. See Ms. Zamrom if you have any questions. The Game Club will be meeting tomorrow and Friday in room 181 until 5 p.m. Our D&D group has started the Dragon of Ice Speak campaign. Other games will also be available. If you missed the call-out meeting last semester, you can still join. See Ms. Damron if you have any questions. The registration period for the Indianapolis Youth Leadership Academy is now open. The Academy is a free one-week leadership development program for young adults who will be 15 through 18 years of age in June. Normally, our registration period has gone into the month of April. However, the class is filling up and there will be no guarantees we will have seats available after February. All of the information, including the dates, location, classes taught, contact information, and an audiophile registration form can be found on the website, www.indieyouthleadership.com. If you have a positive attitude, a good work ethic, and a desire to succeed, and to understand how to become an effective leader, building teams, and being more productive in whatever career you might choose, this academy is for you. Take a look at the website and then consider your life as a follower or as a leader. There will be a call-out meeting for boys golf on Wednesday, January 19th in room 116, immediately after school. All boys interested in playing golf for LC, please attend. We will discuss preseason workouts. Get ahead of the ball in your math class by attending after-school tutoring sessions. Tutoring will begin Tuesday, January 18th from 3:45 to 5 p.m. in Mr. Tyler's room, 131, and continue every Tuesday and Wednesday for the remainder of the year. All are welcome to attend at any level. The LC National Honor Society will be sponsoring our next blood drive on Thursday. Please consider donating during this critical time of blood shortage and need. Use a QR code or link in the Canvas announcements to sign up or see members of the LC National Honor Society during lunch this week. Here are a few scholarships that are due in January. The Ronald McDonald House Scholarship. Applications are due January 20th. And the Tuskegee Airmen Scholarship due on January 25th. Please contact your guidance counselor for assistance. Set construction for the thespian play will continue all week in the auditorium. This week, Team Works representatives will be at LC on Thursday during all lunch blocks. Remember, the ideal candidates for the 2022 Team Works Summer Program will be a current sophomore or junior. All grade levels are encouraged to apply. Preferably have a 2.5 or higher GPA. Preferably be eligible for free and reduced price lunch. Be able to work June 8th through July 15th, 2022, from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. Have an interest in growing professionally throughout their high school experience. Have an interest in committing to our year-round program. TeamWorks Pro application link, teamworks.org/apply/. Attention seniors, applications for the LTSF scholarships are now being accepted. The deadline for submission is February 7th. Contact Nancy Liss at nancyliss@msdlt.k12.in.us or at 317-423-8300 for more information. Today's vocabulary word is staccato, an adjective meaning cut short or apart in performing. Disconnected, abrupt, disjointed. Each sound is clearly and sharply separated from the others. Did you know Alexander Hamilton was born on this date in 1755? He was one of the founding fathers of the United States. He was also a well-respected statesman and a successful military leader. Born out of wedlock in mid-18th century, he spent his childhood among the lowest rung of the white society in St. Croix. Starting to work at the age of 9, He later received informal education from his mentors before being sent to the King's College, New York, to be trained as a doctor. Here, he was quickly drawn into politics, writing his first published article at the age of 17. Later, he joined the War of Independence and came close to General Washington, who, on becoming President of the United States, made him the first Secretary of Treasury. In this new avatar, Hamilton founded the nation's financial policy, helping the government to tide over the chaos it had inherited from the Revolution. A supporter of strong federal government, he also played a significant role in the ratification of the new Constitution and held slavery morally wrong. Hamilton's portrait is depicted on the front of the U.S. $10 bill since 1928. His statues, erected in different parts of the country, as well as buildings and geographic sites named after him, continue to carry his legacy, along with the award-winning Broadway musical that carries his last name. He died in 1804, at the age of 49. Celebrity birthdays: Devin Rattray is 45, Amanda Peet is 50, Mary J. Blige is 51, and Kyle Richards is 53. This has been today's current. Thank you for joining us. Stay positive and test negative, Bears.
No, we don't talk about Bruno. Hey, good living fear when I start.